everyone, Kelly here, and today I want to talk about my plan for reading series in 2022. So last year when I was creating my plans for 2021, I put on my plans that I really wanted to finish some series that I was reading, and I didn't really accomplish that to my satisfaction. Like, I did finish some, but there were a lot of series that I had started like many years ago and haven't even touched for a couple years. And so I just really didn't accomplish what I wanted to. And I think the problem was that I didn't have a plan. So this year I want to create a plan for 2022 so I actually can maybe not finish all these series, but at least continue them so I don't have to keep rereading the first book in these series, because some of these I have read the first book several times because I keep thinking I'm going to continue. And in terms of a plan, I didn't want to just create a TBR for the whole year. I didn't want to say like January I'm going to do this series, and February I'm going to do this series. I didn't want to like assign it, because I feel like when I assign myself things, I just don't do it. I don't know what it is, if it's just like I don't want to be pigeonholed into like doing a specific thing, or I don't want to fulfill a task. I don't know. It doesn't work for me to make lists. So what I've decided I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of the series that I want to continue in or finish, and I'm going to put the name of the series on a piece of paper, put it in a jar, and make kind of like a TBR jar. And every month I'm going to pull out, I don't know, say like three series, and that way it'll give me options. So say I'm not in the mood for a middle grade series, I might choose the adult series or whatever. Most of these are fantasy, so I can't say necessarily different genres, but maybe I'm not in the mood for that specific series, so it gives me some wiggle room. So if I pull up three, I say that I will have to continue one of those three. Or if I get, you know, excited, I might like read from all three of those series. But it'll give me a little more direction and help me keep this like goal in mind every single month if I'm actually drawing something out. I also want to start new series, because I have a problem that I end up buying like tons of books that are the first in a series and then never start them because I feel like I have to accomplish my old series. And I just need to realize that I need to be starting series as well as continuing series. So I'm also going to create another jar that is full of all of the series I want to start that I own, and have both jars, and I will just pull from them every month to kind of like keep myself going on these series. And some of these I will probably have to reread the first book, but you know, other ones I'll be ready to just keep going and maybe finish and hopefully just read more series. I own so many of these books, and some of them I own the whole rest of the series, and I just need to read them. So that is my plan for 2022. I also in this video wanted to show you all of the series that I wanted to continue, the series that'll go inside that jar to pick from. And I also want to show you all the ones that will possibly be started. So obviously I won't start all of those series because there's so many of them, but I'm going to show you everything that I'm going to put in the jars. And basically also the other thing I'm going to do is that if I pull out a series and I don't pick it as one of my three, I'm going to put that paper back in so that that series will come up again, hopefully throughout the year. So let's start with the series that I have already started. I want to start with the books that I own, and then I'll talk about the ones that I don't own. I'm also putting those on the list because even though I don't own them, or maybe I only own an e-copy of them, I want to like keep moving on those series too. The first one I have is the Cursebreakers trilogy. I have read the first book in the series, and I still have these two books to go. Because I have so many, I'm not going to go into details about what each of these series about. This is like starts off as a Beauty and the Beast retelling. It's a fantasy. And then the next series I have is the Remnant Chronicles, which is also a young adult fantasy. This one's a little more politically driven. I have read the first book twice because, like I said, I was starting it again. So I reread it again so that I would continue. And I did start this one. I just don't know if I'll finish it. We only have one more week in the year at the point I'm filming this, so I don't know if I'll finish this, but I have already moved on in this series, but I still have the third book as well, so it'll still go in the jar, because even if I finish that second book, I want to make sure that I read the third book as well. The next series I have is the Wingfeather Saga. I have read the first book in this series of four books, and so I still have books 2, 3, and 4 to go. And this was a new one I just started in 2021, and I really enjoyed it and would like to see how it turns out. The next one I have is another quartet, you know, series with four books in it, and that is The Immortals by Tamara Pierce. And I read the first book twice, once again, and I have started the second book this month. So once again, I might finish this in 2021, but in case I don't, this will be going back in the jar, and I still have the last two books in the series. So there are two, potentially three more books I have to read in that series. The next one is one that I'll probably have to reread at the beginning of the series. This is the Steel and Fire series by Jordan Rivett. This is a YA fantasy, and I read the first three books, and it's been about 2 years. So I probably will listen to those again on audiobook and then pick up the last two books in the series. And then another one by Jordan Rivett, the same author. I just read the first book in this series, The Seabound Chronicles, about like 3 months ago, so I don't need to reread it, but I do want to read the next two books. There's also a prequel, maybe more than one prequel, that if I like these two, maybe I'll get to the prequel as well. And then I have one that I haven't read the first book in probably 3 years, so I will have to reread it, and that's the Mistborn trilogy, the first era. And yeah, I read Mistborn, I would say, almost 3 whole years ago, and I don't remember enough of it to go on, so I would, if I pull it out of the jar, I will reread the first one and then hopefully move on to the next one. And then I have the Inkheart trilogy. I read Inkheart recent enough that I wouldn't have to reread it. It was a reread anyways. This is a reread of a series. I read it probably like 10 years ago or something like that. And so I won't have to reread the first one. I'd like to continue and finish that off. Next, I have the Ark of the Scythe trilogy. I did start Thunderhead a few months ago, but didn't finish it. I'm not going to finish it before the end of the year because I already have those two books that I'm in the middle of. So this one will go in the jar and I'll probably start it over again. And I have the last two books in that series to read. Next, I have the Study series by Maria V. Snyder, which my covers don't match, which kind of makes me grumpy. And I got rid of the first one because the first one I had in a mass market paperback, and that was even making me more grumpy that they weren't lined up on the shelf right. And this one, I read the first book, and I'm pretty sure I won't have to reread that because I read the series a while ago and was rereading it. So since I've read it twice, I think I could keep going. This is also one where she wrote another trilogy after this. So if I finish this trilogy, the Study series now has a second trilogy in it. So maybe I will continue on to that one if I like this series. Like I said, I've read it before, but I don't remember much about how it ends. And next I have the Queen's Thief series, and I have read the first two books. I read the first book twice, so I can move on to the second book in 2021. I read it just, I think maybe over the summer, so I'm okay if I pull this out soon, I won't have to reread that one. And I own three of the books, but then there's one more book in the series, so there'll be four that I would have to read. And then I have the Charles Lennox Mysteries, which is probably the only non-fantasy that I've had in this pile so far. And this one's like a mystery series that takes place during Victorian times. And they have both a main series and a prequel. I own two books and there's one more in the main series. And then this is the second prequel. And then there's one more prequel. There's like a prequel trilogy. So that means I technically have five more books in order to be up to date. This is an ongoing series. So five to be where he's currently at in terms of publishing. Next, I have the Keeper of the Lost series. This is a middle grade fantasy, and these books are huge, and that's why I kind of took a giant break from it because it was taking me so long to get through these. And I have book 6, 7, and 8 that I own. There's a book 8.5 that is not a novella, so I'm not sure why it's called 8.5. So if I like these three, I'll buy 8.5, and then this is an ongoing series as well. And then I have Castle in the Air by Diana Wynne Jones. This is a companion novel to Howl's Moving Castle, and all three in this trilogy are companion novels, but I would still like to keep going while the world is fresh in my mind. And then another one that's companion novels in the same world, I have Disenchanted, The Trials of Cinderella, which is part of the Time series, and each of these are kind of like fairy tale retellings that have kind of a social justice theme. And so this is the second one that's a companion novel, and then there's a third one after I finish this one. And then that's all the ones that I own physically that I would want to read. I have a few that I own ebooks or audiobooks of. One is the Dead Djinn universe, and this one I have read the first novella, and then there's a short story, a novella, and then a full novel. I also have an e-copy of the short story and novella, and then would have to buy the novel when it comes time to read that. And then I have the Stolen Kingdom series, which is like a kind of princess fairy tale retelling series. I have read the first one and I own the next two on ebook, and then there's a fourth book. So I have three books yet to read, but I own two of them already. And then I have Skyward, which I read Skyward, and then I have an audiobook of Skyward, the second book in the series, and the third book. And then I would have to get the two novellas. So I don't know if I would need to reread Skyward, but I might, because it's been a while now. And it might just be better now that I own all of them on audiobook through Audible. I might just listen to them all in a row before the next book comes out, which I think will be like 2023. And then the series that I don't own the next book in, there's not that many. There's only six of them. I have the Gaithers Sisters trilogy, which these are middle grade, I guess, historical fiction, because it takes place in the 1960s. And I read the first one and I have two more in this series to read. And then I have Lady Sherlock series, which this is kind of like a retelling of Sherlock Holmes with a female Sherlock as the main character. And I have listened to the first two of these and I really like them on audiobook. So I'll probably just keep getting the audiobooks from the library, and there are four more books out. Hopefully there's an audio recording of all the rest of them, because kind of once I start a series on audiobook, I want to keep going. So hopefully we have audiobooks for all the rest of these. And then I have the Wayward Children series. And this one, I technically only need to read one more to be up to date, but I want to reread one of the ones I had read before. And I'm not rereading them in order. So I want to reread book three. I have never read book four, but I have read books five and six. So that's confusing, but basically just know, in order to be up to date at the end of 2021, I need to read two more books. I'm not counting the next one that's coming out in 2022. I'm only counting books that are already out so far. So I would have two more books to read to be up to date on that one. And then I have the Earthsea series, and I read one book in this series and there are five more books to read. And then I have the Vanderbeekers, which I am currently reading book one in this series, and there are four more books to read. This will be one that I will finish before the end of the year, because I wanted to read it around Christmas time. And so that one will be a started series by the time we get to 2022. So I figured I would put that in, that I want to read those. All right, so those are all the series that I have started so far and are hoping to continue. Maybe not all of those, but you know, I will pick from those out of a jar to continue. Now I want to just show you really quick the series that I own the first book. And some of these I own the entire series, and so I want to put these in a jar as well and pick from, so that I can keep going on the books that I own. I did separate these by like duologies, trilogies, and longer series, just because that's how I wanted to organize them. But I'm going to go through these really quick. Let me know if there's ones that you really love, because even if I don't pull it out of the jar, maybe I'll just get in the mood to start something, and you can let me know if you really like them. Most of these are fantasy. There are a couple that might be contemporary, but yeah, it just turns out that I get a lot of fantasy series and then maybe don't start them. So starting with the duologies, I have Parable the Sower and The Killing Moon, Serafina, Pivot Point, Peter Nimble and His Fantastic Eyes, The War That Saved My Life, The Wild Robot, Skeleton Man. This is a two-book collection, so it's called The Legend of Skeleton Man because it has both The Skeleton Man and Return of the Skeleton Man, Monstrous Devices, and Watch Hollow. Now on to the trilogies I have. If you notice from those duologies, I'm not saying the name of the series. I'm just saying the name of the first book, because it just takes too much effort to like know what all these series are actually called. And so yeah, on to my trilogies. I have several of these. I have Akata Witch, which this was just a duology, but now there's a third one coming out next year. So I don't know if it's gonna be a longer series, but for now it's a trilogy. The Knife of Never Letting Go, Renegades, The Fifth Season, Ember, Pines, The Diviners, Book Scavenger, Blood Red Road, Daughter of Smoke and Bone, Touch of Power, Everlost, Emily of New Moon, The Spy in the Silver Palace, The River Man, The Golden Compass, A Dash of Trouble, A Tale Dark and Grim, Dragon Slippers, Last Day on Mars, and Finding Langston. And I have one more, and technically this is not a trilogy. It was meant to be one book, but since I have three books, I'm gonna count The Lord of the Rings. I have The Hobbit, which I already read, and then I have the Lord of the Rings. I'm just gonna treat it like a trilogy because I doubt that I'm gonna pick it up all as one. So I might as well just put it in the jar so that if I read one, I can put that piece of paper back in and then get to the next one. And then I have all the series that are longer than three books. I have Still Life, A Path Begins, The Water Horse, The Trials of Morgan Crow, The Land, The Screaming Staircase, A Wrinkle in Time, The Book Wanderers, Gregor the Overlander, The Wishing Spell, The School for Good and Evil, Serafina and the Black Cloak, The President's Daughter, The Beekeeper's Apprentice, Wool, and Solace. And then I have just a few that I have the entire box set. I would like to start James Herriot. These are his collection of memoirs. I got them the British version that has 8 books. If you get it in America, I think it's only 3 books. Like, they condense ones into just 3 published books. And then I have the Enchanted Forest Chronicles. And then I have the Chronicles of Narnia, which would be a reread, I think. But I don't know if I ever read the last 2 books. That's why I think it's a reread. I know I've read the first one. Yeah, I know I don't read the first 5 because I remember those. But I don't remember the last 2. So I'm just putting the whole series on there because I would like to start it over. I might read at least The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe with my daughter and then do the rest of them on my own. So that's it. I realized as I pulled out all of these books that I probably should have just put pictures up because this is a whole lot of books that I just pulled off my shelf and have to reorganize. But, oh well, you know, you guys like to see the actual book. But as you can tell, there's a lot of series that I want to continue, and I own a lot of series that I would like to start. So I think having this like plan to have the jars and pull from them will help me to at least like put those series in my mind instead of just forgetting that I even own them and then getting to the point where I have to start from the beginning all over again. Hopefully there's not that many that I will have to start from the beginning and then I can keep the momentum going. Maybe this, if this works this year, this can just keep going, that I always have a jar for series to encourage myself to keep reading. Does anybody else have trouble remembering to finish series? I know some people just, they start a series and they binge the whole series. I just can't usually do that as a mood reader because usually I'll like finish a book and I'm like, oh, now I want to go read something completely different. And so it's hard for me to read a series straight through. Is anybody else like that? Or am I just like the weird person that never finishes series? So that's it for me for this video. I will talk to you next time. Bye.